told us, I don't know if it's true or lie, they told us that this road, from Olule down to Yanoba is for state government. I don't know if it's true. And from there downwards is for federal, is federal. Now, if it's true, and the Sanwo-Olu have entered, which all of us voted him in, believing that he's the Messiah we have, or that he's going to help us out. If that is the truth, then I expected him as a man that office as the governor to take very care of this road, because this road brings a lot of money in this Lagos state.
So, since then, after 2 weeks now, I came here at Moto Hang Up here. So, this morning till now, I've been trying to find if there's anything to get Moto out of the doorway. So, we have been struggling. I have hired Toro here to drive the Moto. Still, yes, no way. We have been looking for somebody to help. Before you cross from there to Mazamaza, and follow Lagos-Ibadan, you spend like 3-4 days before you get to Big that's what we hold on.
In fact, if they can attend to this road from here to Ogoko, at least if only thing that they did for us this year, at least it can be the only ones that I can go to Ogoko and come back. Only one once for me to go Ogoko and come back. It is very, very hard. You understand? Because the road is very bad.
For so one government, let us do something about this road. The road is very, very bad. If you do go around, look around, it's dirty. Everywhere is dirty. No vehicle.
So my experience on this road is terrible. It's terrible. That even we ourselves as the businessmen do not go out with our car or come in. Oftentimes we park our cars inside the market. Before we can go, we park our cars inside the market before we can go. Could you believe on a particular day, a customer called me from morning till evening. He's still on the hold up. And what did I say? I told her, okay, come back tomorrow. She said she will not be able to come again. That even the market we are selling here, they are selling in other places like Lagos Island. It makes us to lose our customers.
You can see the situation, how I managed to buy this area. See, I've been very rough. I've been so, in fact, it's unbearable. So the area, the soonest the government do something about it, the better for us, especially with the businessmen.
This nation is losing a heavy amount of money on a daily basis. Because all these people that are coming from Togo and other places, they are no longer coming. If you call them, they say, there is no road. There is no road. Some of us, we have our goods. Sometimes we bring some goods from Ghana or from every other places. But the problem we are facing, the road. Sometimes it will take 2, 3 weeks, 4 weeks, 1 month for a truck, single truck to enter inside the market. For that reason, those that have it inside the market, they increase the price. That even the ordinary man cannot be able to afford it. It's terrible. Just imagine, we import a goods from overseas that carries these fancy bombs and other things. Getting at the point of entering the market, the container will fail down. All the things are damaged. No insurance that covers it. You lose the money, start from scratch again. So we are facing a terrible situation in this particular area, especially this underbridge. Right from Abulado to Balax.
A week or thereabout after his warning, he first visited this area, so he sought it by saying, I promise that you're going to do something about it. If you look at the other side, that make it to be more terrible. The problem we're having this side, nothing has been done. So we believe in him that soonest we will come and finish and fulfill his promise anyway.
Because if you witness what happened last week, you see a man calling people at their back just to cross them. Because the rain or the water is very, very dirty. The gutters are blocked. The water is not flowing. The road is not normal. So it's a terrible condition we are passing out. I might not be able to calculate it on myself as individual, but I know that I have lost at least 4 major customers I have, which is a very big blow on me as a person. So talk of others, because I'm a distributor of a company. Now, whenever there is a heavy hold up like this, I do turnover of 5-6 million. You can see the margin. It's a terrible condition. But I pity those that import their goods from outside. I pity them. offering price their container for that. Those people, they cannot be able to calculate their own, because they talk about the margin they bought the dollar. They suffer even for them to travel and come back, take the low risk for the goods to enter their shop if they fall at the bottom of their market. It's pricey and terrible. I expect them to repair the road. We are not asking them much. We are asking them at least that essential thing, road, light, and just water, just normal thing. We can find our way out. We're not going to repair the road for us because it's their duty.